I know this cake has always been on your to-bake list, and if not, it's time you put it there right away. We're making the richest, darkest chocolate cake with an indulgent chocolate fudge frosting. It's a devil's food cake with an intense chocolate flavor, which I know you love, so let's get started. Let's start by making the buttermilk for the cake. All you need to do is to combine some milk and white vinegar. I'll give it a good mix and set this aside for a few minutes. Meanwhile, let's start working on our dry ingredients. I'm going to sift everything in. I'm using all-purpose flour, which is maida, both baking powder and baking soda, and cocoa powder. A devil's food cake would always have a light and airy sponge, which is why sifting your dry ingredients is extremely important. Now finally, in a separate bowl, let's start working on our wet ingredients. First in goes caster sugar, which is also called super fine sugar, and vegetable oil. You could use any oil which has a neutral taste and smell. Using my whisk, I'm going to mix both the ingredients together very well so that I incorporate a lot of air into my sponge. So I'll be making an eggless version of the cake today, which is why I'm using homemade dahi. You could also use hung curd or Greek yogurt. But if you want to make this cake with egg, you could add 2 eggs instead of the yogurt. So this is where you add your yogurt or your eggs, whatever you're using. I'm using homemade dahi. So that goes in along with a splash of vanilla extract, and using my whisk, I'm going to mix everything together. Alright, this looks good. So our wet mix, dry mix and our buttermilk are ready. And now all we need to do is to put it all together. I'll start adding the dry mix into the wet ingredients in 3 batches, and I'll alternate each batch with buttermilk. Putting it together in 3 batches actually helps me ensure that each batch of dry mix is incorporated properly without me actually over-mixing the batter, which would knock out all the air that we've incorporated so far and result in a dense and heavy cake. Alright, so the devil's food cake batter is ready. Now this goes into 2 6-inch round pans that I've greased with melted butter or vegetable oil and lined with parchment paper. I'll then bake this in a preheated oven at 180 degrees Celsius for about 30 to 35 minutes. While the cakes are baking in the oven, let's get the work started on our frosting. So a devil's food cake gets its name from the fact that it's extremely sinful. So I'll be layering it with a chocolate fudge frosting, which makes it just that. For the frosting, I'm taking 1 cup of salted softened butter into a large bowl. And using my electric mixer, I'll beat this at high speed so that it becomes light and fluffy. Alright, this looks good. And now into this, I'll sift in icing sugar and cocoa powder. I'll give it an initial mix using my spatula so that the icing sugar doesn't go around flying everywhere. And once that's done, I'll again beat the frosting at high speed using my electric mixer until it's light and fluffy. Now into this goes 1 cup melted chocolate. I'm using dark chocolate today, and using my electric mixer, I'll beat this in as well. And now one final ingredient, which is cream. I'm using fresh cream. You could also make this frosting with heavy cream. The only thing that you need to keep in mind is to warm your cream slightly before you add it in. My chocolate fudge frosting looks so good. Now this goes into the fridge for about 10 minutes. And once it becomes firm, we can start assembling our cake. To assemble the cake, I'm going to take out the cool layers from the cake pan and then place them onto a cake stand. Now on each layer, I'll spread a generous amount of the chocolate fudge frosting. To give my cake a taller look, I made an extra layer. There's chocolate cake and then there's this devil's chocolate cake which you need to make to experience an overload of chocolate. So I hope you guys will try this rich decadent recipe at home and share it by tagging me on Instagram at Shivesh17. I promise to keep coming back to you with new recipes. Until then, happy baking and take care.